were academics, and they wound up in Santa Barbara. Tell me a little bit about your early life.
Well, I was born in Oxford, England. My parents are both from India, but they were teaching philosophy at Oxford. And to my eternal delight and debt, they came over to Santa Barbara in about 1965. Mm-hmm. My father was working at the Center for Study of Democratic Institutions mm-hmm. in Montecito, and also both my parents were teaching at UCSB. So I've never really been a grown-up in Santa Barbara, but I've been taking holidays here for 44 years and would gladly take holidays perpetually.
Yeah. Well, you're someone who's traveled all over the world, one of really the world travelers. How does Santa Barbara fit into the big picture for you?
I suppose it's always been a refuge and a sanctuary mm-hmm. from the real world, so it feels ever less like that to me. I feel we're being sucked into Los Angeles very quickly and turning into Santa Monica North. But still, everything I love about Santa Barbara, which mostly has to do with the views and the long horizons and the mm-hmm. nature, is as pristine as it always has been. Mm-hmm. So I can see how it's irresistible for the mm-hmm. whole globe, really.
Well, now, one of the sort of formative events for you as a person in Santa Barbara was a fire.
Yes.
Tell me a little bit about that.
Well, I was caught in the middle of the Painted Cave fire in 1990. My family house is way up on Old San Marcos Road near the Trout Club, so we're almost in the line of fire, whatever is happening. And I think within about 10 minutes of the Painted Cave fire breaking out, it was surrounding my house. Mm-hmm. And my parents were out of town at the time, but I was alone in the house, and I went to call the fire department and the police station, went up to the living room and found myself surrounded by 70-foot flames. Mm-hmm. And in such a situation, did the stupidest thing in the world, which is to grab my mother's cat and jump into a car. So, I started to drive down Old San Marcos Road and then noticed that I was literally ringed by flames and there was no way out. And the smoke was so thick that I couldn't even see or be seen by the helicopters above. And there was just one man standing in the road, bare-chested in his shorts, a good Samaritan from Solvang who had come to help out. And he had a water track, and he essentially saved my life and his own. So we were stuck there for 2.5 hours, and then we were able to go a little further down the road to a place from which I could see my house and my whole life go up in flames. But in some ways, living in Santa Barbara, you always know that fire is one of your most loyal mm-hmm. companions. And also, I saw it as a liberation as well as a loss.
Absolutely. When there's the opening chapter in the